In case you missed the news, China just released a game-changing open source AI that's blowing away ChatGPT, Claude, and other Western competitors. Or so the hype says.
China's latest AI breakthrough has leapfrogged the world.
DeepSeek, and yesterday it became the most downloaded.
I think we should take the development out of China very, very seriously.
In this video, we're gonna take a very practical look at DeepSeek. I'll show you how to use 80% of it in 5 minutes, and then we'll compare the quality, cost, and privacy across some other well-known models. Now to access DeepSeek, click the card at the top or use the link in the description. Let's dive in. Here we are on the DeepSeek homepage. And yes, in order to use DeepSeek, you must sign up for an account. I personally recommend using an email address and password versus connecting your Google account directly for privacy reasons. Be aware that you do need to use a personal email, not a business email, otherwise your sign up will be rejected. Once you've included the correct email address, set up your password, and then ask for a code. Once you receive the code from your email, plug it in here and then click sign up, and I'll see you on the other side. Okay, we are now in the DeepSeek interface, and the first thing to do is to turn on DeepThink. And for our first prompt, we'll start off easy. Well, it is easy for us, but it has stumped ChatGPT in the past. After about 15 seconds, DeepSeek returns the right answer. Now, you might be wondering, why did it take 15 seconds for such an easy answer? That's because this is a reasoning model. And what that means is because the AI is given more time to think and reason, the accuracy and the precision of its answers increases. What's unique about DeepSeek is that we get exposed to its thought process. So you see, it starts off by trying to count the R's letter by letter, and then it second guesses itself and checks itself multiple times until it arrives at the correct answer. It's also funny that it hints there might be a common mistake where people think it's only two R's. Let's now try another example where this chain of thought reasoning will be more helpful. It's a classic word problem. Alice can paint a fence in 4 hours, Bob can do it in 3. How long does it take for them to do it together? No surprises here, it came up with the correct answer. But let's take a look at the reasoning behind this. Now I mentioned this term chain of thought reasoning, and that's exactly what DeepSeek is doing. This mimics human reasoning by breaking down complex problems into steps and thinking through each step to end up with a more accurate final answer. And the cost is extra thinking time. Now you generally want this behavior for really complex problems, not like the two that we've just seen. And to prove that we don't need it, I'm going to ask a fun twist on the work rate problem without DeepThink R1. The answer here will come back almost instantly. As expected, we got the answer and we didn't need the complex reasoning. So what's an example of a complex problem? Check this one out. Pretend it's 1954, which is 5 years before we started a global effort to eradicate smallpox. How would you do it if you had a year to prepare? And just like before, there's a clear thought process that happens before the response is given. Now the response here is quite interesting, so I'll scroll through it slowly so you can pause the video and read it if you would like. Now we're gonna do some side-by-side direct comparisons between ChatGPT and DeepSeek. And to be fair to DeepSeek, we're gonna start a new chat by clicking on the button in the top right corner. We'll use DeepThink R1 on the left and then ChatGPT 01 on the right. And for some brief context, ChatGPT 01 is the model that's been most compared to DeepThink R1, but it's not ChatGPT's best reasoning model. More on that later. Let's get on to the first question. Let's start with a question with a lot of ambiguity. We'll ask both AIs to generate a step-by-step guide for improving productivity, but avoid recommending tools or apps. I'm gonna rate the answer subjectively, so let's see what they come up with. Both AIs come up with solid plans. DeepSeek's is more tactical and detailed, while ChatGPT's is generally more strategic. Since you could modify the prompt to account for this disparity, I'd normally rate these about even, except for the fact that ChatGPT 01 was several seconds faster. Let's move on to a new test about practical decision making. Here, we'll pretend that we're raising money for our school baseball team. We'll ask the AI for three different approaches and which has the highest chance of succeeding. Both AIs came up with solid options, but only ChatGPT made the recommendation for the best one. DeepSeek, on the other hand, reasoned that the best option was based on their strengths, but did not include this in the output. And once again, ChatGPT 01 was much faster, thinking for 6 seconds compared to DeepSeek's 54. Let's move on to a coding example. My favorite AI test is to create a two-player Pong game. Let's see what they both come up with. Both AIs took about the same amount of time. Let's check out what DeepSeek came up with first. At the bottom of any HTML fragment in DeepSeek, you'll see a button, Run HTML. When you click it, it launches and renders the HTML code. Now here we have a working two-player Pong game, but we can't see the paddle of player one, even though we know it's there. ChatGPT's output is better, but with a worse experience. You see, it just gives you the code, but you're not able to run it in line. So I saved the code and launched it separately. Here we do have a working two-player Pong game and paddles on both sides. Neat. So ChatGPT is definitely winning this practical race so far. But remember, I'm paying for use of ChatGPT 01, but not for DeepSeek. Let's try a creative exercise writing a haiku. Final poems aside, it is fun to watch how DeepSeek reasons about what makes a good haiku. Pause the video here if you want to take a further look. Otherwise, let's look at the poems. Silicon mind hums, learning from data streams, human dreams reborn. Versus mind sparks code to life, silicon thoughts shape our world. Boundless dreams arise. I think the DeepSeek haiku is more cohesive, so it wins this round for me. Let's now test another capability, search. All large language models are trained on some set of data, but they won't be up with current events unless they're allowed to search the internet. That's why you have this search button in both DeepSeek and in ChatGPT. Unfortunately, ChatGPT 01 does not support search, so we're gonna have to quote unquote downgrade to 4.0. Let's run this question about tourist attractions for locals in Rome. Well, funny enough, with the popularity of DeepSeek this week, this has become a common occurrence. I'll come back to you in a few minutes when the service starts working again. I'm back, and unfortunately, the search service is still not working. So I reran this query on DeepSeek without search, and it came up with a number of good suggestions alongside ChatGPT. In this case, I'm giving it to ChatGPT because its search service works, and search means that I have references I can click on if I want to learn more. Now, after that demo, you may be wondering what's all the hype about, because 01 was at least marginally better on most of those tasks. And the answer boils down to two main points. First is that building and using DeepSeek's model is way more affordable. And the second is that it's open source. When I say it's more affordable, let me show you what I mean. All of these large language models cost money to train. Meta's open source Llama 3.1 model, reportedly $60 million to train. OpenAI 4.0, $100 million. DeepSeek V3, which we looked at for one query, only $5.6 million. Now, this might just be one model training, but make no mistake, American companies are spending tens of billions of dollars on AI training. On its own, this is already a huge breakthrough. Then you have to remember that the United States restricted high-performance AI chips from being sent to China over a year ago. So with less money and worse processing power, DeepSeek was still able to create a model which rivals the best of American innovation. Here you can see its performance on several AI benchmarks, including advanced mathematics, so-called Google-proof PhD-level questions, and coding questions. The good news is that those cost savings are passed on to you. And to help you see how that works, let's briefly review how prompts cost money. Pretend you ask an AI how many R's are in strawberry. One of the first steps of parsing this prompt is to turn it into tokens. Tokens are close to words, but they can just be parts of words too. All these tokens get sent into the AI, and then the AI sends a set of tokens back. Now, most of these tokens cost money. Input tokens are some amount, and usually output tokens are a lot more. Now let's consider the token cost across four different models. DeepSeek R1 is substantially cheaper. So what does this mean in terms of a subscription cost? Right now, you have to pay $20 a month for ChatGPT 4.0, and that only gives you 50 messages per week for ChatGPT 01. If you want near unlimited 01, you have to pay the pro plans hefty $200 a month. And on the DeepSeek website, there's not even a way to pay right now. But if there were, we're looking at something like $7 as the equivalent to the $200 a month plan. Now, it's not quite a fair comparison because ChatGPT has memories, it's able to process custom instructions, it seems to have a more reliable search function, and you get access to other features like image generation and ChatGPT projects. That said, because DeepSeek is open source, I'm sure there will be many other software companies building these features on top of it. Now, before we wrap up, here's an important note on privacy. The DeepSeek web interface is run out of China, and if you have any doubt about that, try asking it a question like this. And there is no way of opting out of DeepSeek using your data to train its models. And by the way, if you're worried about that and you use ChatGPT, make sure you turn off the Improve the Model for Everyone switch. Now, in theory, the solution to all these privacy concerns is to run the open source version of DeepSeek on your laptop. So hit that subscribe button so you don't miss our next tutorial on that. This is David, and I'll see you in the next video.